Welcome all of you, Nana here. And then in this session, we are going to have a look at the retroactive pricing. And I was making a mistake and my student Anita corrected me. So I will now show you about how to do that now. Thanks, Anita. More than share. So in this place, what I'm going to do is I will now create one blanket agreement. Now. Click on it. I will now go to the create agreement and then create a blanket. So it's a B01. I'm not putting the supplier over here now. And then click on create the blanket agreement. I'm going to create it now. I'm going to drop it down and then choose the site. Site one, I'm choosing it now. Okay, fine. The contact also I can choose now. And then click on create. We are creating it. We are creating the BPA now. So the BPA is under creation now. So in a BPA, we can negotiate the terms and conditions, and then we can even offer a discount. That is the biggest power of a BPA actually. So, and then normally you will now have the start and end date always mentioned. Now. So let me put yesterday's date now, and then end date I'm not putting it. The amount agreed is going to be the controlling factor for all of these that gets copied in the amount limit. So all the cumulative releases against the BPA, which is a SPO, so they cannot exceed the amount limit of the BPA. If I'm going to release one SPO against this BPA, then it cannot exceed 10,000. And all the SPOs put together cannot exceed this. Go on. And then I go there. I will now add line. I click on plus now. I'm going to add line. So item is B01. B0101. And then give it tab now. I'm putting the item. So B01. I've forgotten the item. On this one. So B0110. So supplier is calling at what this one? B01. Sub item. So we can very well mention the supplier item on the supplier item, but we cannot, what happens, populate this item on the item. Fine. Our cataloged item cannot be put as a supplier item. So click on this edit icon. I'm going to edit it, and then he's offering a discount. So we have already seen about the MR in the lines region, as well as agreement amount, agreement quantity, everything we have already completed now in our training. So you go there, click on this, and then price breaks. I'm going to click on price breaks. We'll now go there and then we'll now say org. Org is what? B011 and then give it tab now. And then the location is B01 and then log one. I'm going to wait. So for this, so discounts are basically org location specific. And if I go there, go for 100 now. And then here, I go there, I will now give a 20% discount. So it's now 0.8 if you're going to buy more than 100 now. So this much is not done. Fine with that. So afterwards, what we are specifying it in this place, you go there. Will not give okay now. Fine. We are now giving a discount. So you can even have multiple slabs. And then here, the price breaks should not be cumulative for a retroactive pricing. That was a mistake I was making now. Fine. So if you want to use the retroactive pricing, cumulative price breaks will not work now. Fine. It has to be non-cumulative. It must be non-cumulative. This is a mistake I was making in the previous one. So now I have corrected it. Fine. Thanks, Anita, for this. Now, fine. Click on OK. So price break must be non-cumulative. I've given it now. Click on it. And then in the controls, we have now enabled all the controls actually. Fine, go to the controls. Then you can now see automatic sourcing is enabled. So when I make a new SPO, what happens? Because of the sourcing, it will automatically reference this 3009. I click on submit, by which what happens? We are now submitting this BPA now. 3009 is now submitted for approval. It is for the B0110 item. Fine, go to it. And then wait for some time and then afterwards see whether it is approved now. So go there and then click on it and then we'll now go to the manage agreements now. Manage agreements. So 3009 is agreement on which we're doing it now. 3009. And then click on search now. You can also see it's rejected actually. And somebody, I think probably somebody might have fiddled on the approval process now, fine, because of which is now getting rejected actually. We'll now have a look at the approval process. Right click and then go to duplicate and then now look at the approval process. Somebody might have set the approvals. I initially set up for automatic approval. So somebody might have changed it. And go to the setup and maintenance. And then let me see the approvals for the purchase orders actually. Click on it. And then you go to the search now. Manage document approvals the one. This is for the purchase order. Manage requisition approvals is for the requisition. So manage document approvals is the purchase order. Click on it now. I'm going to void. And then I'll now see this is the one which has been enabled. Click on the edit rules now. And then let us now make it as automatic. And go the one. So here, whatever the NOC approval required, he has made it. Fine. Go click on the edit. And let us now make it automatic. So it's automatic now. And then click on OK, and then I will now remove the conditions. And will click on it and now deal with the condition. It's not done, fine with that. It's basically automatic now. Click on it and then edit it, and then we'll now say that approval, it's a rule always applies to us. So the conditions no more apply. So we are not changing these ones now, fine. So it's an automatic approval. We click on save and then deploy it. You can deploy it. So once you have this deployed, what happens, it will know, take some time to take effect actually. So what you can do is, we can, after some time, 2 minutes, we can very well go on, then we can do it. You click on it. Once again, I will have a look at it. You click on edit rules, whether the tick mark is there, and say, okay, it's on. So I'll now cancel and then come out of it. Now fine, we'll wait for some few minutes now. Okay, now we'll go there and then go to the manage approvals, manage agreements, and I'm putting 3009. So we'll go to putting 3009 agreement. And click on search. So it's already rejected because of what happened. I'll now go on that, select and then go to actions and then go to edit. And go to edit it. And then in the edit, what happens, I will know how, what happens, the manage approvals will tell you who is going to approve on this point. So we are now given only as an automatic approver. So the application developer will be coming up as an approver. And the person who has created this 3009 is known as application developer. So he has to only, what happens, approve. So that means it's an automatic one. So go there and then we'll now go on the, go ahead and then do it. So it says what, only one person is there. Fine, we'll click on submit, by which, what happens, we'll be getting submitted. And then we'll be getting approved. The document has been submitted for approval. Okay, now against this, what happens, you're now going to create what, one SPO. Fine. So let's go there and then create an SPO. Go there. So click on create order. So I'm now going to create an order. And automatic sourcing is already enabled. And so what happens, the 3009 will be getting defaulted over here. I'm going to choose sub one. Then I'm going to choose the site one. And click on create. We are creating a PPO, SPO. Fine. It's a purchase order. Fine. The SPO. Click on it. And then I know for everything, go there, pull on, and then click on the add items. The moment I add an item, what happens? The BPA, the agreement number, will be getting defaulted because of automatic sourcing. So B0110, and then give a tab now. So when I give a tab, I can also see the agreement 3009 will be coming up here. Yeah. And it will come automatically. Fine. Go there, go for 100 quantities. Go for 100 quantities. So if you go for 100 quantities, you'll be getting a discount. If you go for only 90, what happens, 99, you'll not get the discount. So it'll be, you have to pay full money. So go there, it's $1. So it's 99 is $1. If you go for 101, you will not get a discount. 101 is now enjoying a discount of 10% now. So based upon this, we're not giving you a discount. And then I will now go up, and then I will now save, and then I will now submit. So click on save, and then click on submit. So it's a 2031 is now submitted properly. Now we'll now see the retroactive pricing on the this thing, you know, that you must say, oh, the date is not provided. And go down and then click on the schedules. Go to the schedules and then give one of the dates. Click on it. And then give 2 days. Late. We need to pay. So the requested delivery date or the promised date is a mandatory field. And click on submit. So 2031 is now getting submitted. So it will be getting submitted. Now, what happens? The supplier is now offering more discount. We go there and then we'll now go to this page. So we will now go to what? We'll now go to the manage agreements. So let us now query that 3009 document. 3009. That is 2031, remember? Fine, whatever it was. So let us make a search. Now you're going to edit it. And then you're going to edit it. So we click on edit, and then you're going to make a change because he's now offering 20% discount. I click on edit. So it'll now be creating a change order. I click on yes, now accept it, and then go inside. The change order is now going to be created. So we'll now say what happens. So more discounts all. More discounts. So more discounts is now offered. More discounts is offering. And then you go down and then have a look at it. Everything is okay. So in this place, what happens, you're now offering a more discount. Click on edit, you're now offering a more discount. So in this place, I'm not making a change. You know, so I'm going to make a change. I don't know why the line is getting split into two now. So it's not coming. I'm unable to understand this. So let us say that what happens, the discount percentage is not 20, it's 30%. I don't know. Put on both the lines now. I'm not able to understand about why the line has got split into it. So what happens, you know, see, this is now 30. This also has to come as 30. It's not coming now. Fine, we'll click on it. The 30% discount is not coming about. You know, go that try and delete it now. Click on delete. There's not a meaningless one. You cannot delete this price break because it was previously approved. You enter an end date for the price break. This one thing. So you have to only put an end date. This one thing. You cannot delete it now. It's okay. We'll now leave it as it's not fine. So the start date is not going to end, not coming. Now, whatever is now shown as a 0.7, it's okay. But these attributes are self-service procurement. I need to learn this now. Once I learn it, I'll be teaching you about how to populate these item attributes. But of course, what happens, I used to do it in eBiz on the iProcurement. So it is a similar one for the self-service procurement. I have to learn it now. So click on OK. And if you go to the controls, I can go to the controls. Now, in the retroactive price area, what happens, you are now saying, what happens, you go to the controls now, you go there. retroactive is what happens, initiate process upon approval. And then reprice open orders only. Fine. Whatever is open only you're doing. So if a purchase order is already closed, it will not reprice as such. Fine. And then communicate price updates. So those are the ones we are now selected. So if you remove it, what happens? Even the closed orders will be updated. Fine. Now it's an open order. Fine. 2031 is an open order. Fine. Go click on it. And then I'm going to submit it. So the change has been made. Thank you for submitting. So is a 30% discount instead of 20%. Thank you for submitting now. And remember, the price breaks must be non-cumulative. Then only it will be done. Okay, now. So click on done. Then you can now see that this is undergoing a change. Click on it and then go to the manage agreements. And then the approval process is undergoing now. Right? So the 3009, I go there and then make a query. So click on search. Searching it. It is now undergoing a change. You can now see that whatever the change order spending pop. A change order spending. So once when this is completed, what happens? You'll now be able to see the balance. The released amount will also change to 70 now, because what happens, the 2031, which is now referencing the BPA, so that amount also will be getting changed to 70. So we'll not even refer directly over there. Fine, click on it. There's no undergoing a change. No, fine. We'll go to the manage orders and then go for 2031. So 2031 is the one thing you tap. And then click on search now. And then you can see the final. So now what happens, it will not undergo a change. No, fine. 80 to 70 is going to undergo. No, fine. So keep on searching for it. No, click on it. I'll not keep on searching. So wait for it to get changed actually. Now we can see that a change order icon has come on this. If you click on the change order, what happens? The change order spending now and change order spending. So that icon is coming. And that means what? It is undergoing a change. So 80 has to become 70. So it is now going to go to the spending on search now. MOC, that what happens? It is still going on. They say it takes some time. And then once when it is completed, it will be informing it. 2031, you go there inside. And then you can see the line also will be undergoing a change actually. Then open the order. So it's open with a change. The change icon is the information. It says what a change is spending on. So from the BPA, the change is not coming. And we have on it. And then you know there. It has to become 70 actually. So the orders. You'll now give it done and then come out of it and then again make a re-query on this. On it. So no search on it. Fine. It's already begun. It has now become 70. Okay. So that 30% discount has already come now. On it. So the icon is gone. Fine. Go there. On it. So it does not become there. See this. The 70 ordered is how much? Fine. The price has become 78. So 101 with the 70. Fine. It was previously 0.8 and then now it has become 0.7. So for 101 quantity is what happens now showing you. 101 to 0.7 is 7. That's it. And that is on this now. Fine. So if you go and then do like this now, fine. I don't know how to communicate this price break back to payables basically. If already it is invoiced, when somebody knows it, please tell me about how to communicate it now. Fine. So if I change, if already an invoice is also made, but I'm not really aware of about how to communicate that. In emails, I have already done, you just see my emails records. I really communicated back to the invoice also, if it is already invoice, that kind of thing. But in Fusion, I'm yet to learn that now. Fine. Once when I learn it, I will not tell you about how to do this one. So this is on this now. Fine. Go there, click on it. So in the managed agreements, I will again tell you, if you go there, and then query for the 3009. Go there, click on search now. Go there. If you go on the click on it, underline, click on it, and then you go to the controls. You go to the controls. What happens? You can see not controls in the main region. So click on it, go on the edit this line. So click on the radius. Click on the radius. Now show you that the price break has been changed. What happens? It's the price is what more than 100 is now 70, and there has been approved. And then that is now getting now 70.70 is now raised because 101 quantities are there. And then in this place, if you give what happens, done. And then we'll now have a look at what the main one. The agreement controls, we have to have a look at. Now we have to click on it. We are unable to see the agreement controls. Thank you for details now. So if you click on details, there we can see the agreement controls. And the controls, the controls you can see. And the controls. So this is what it is. So enable retroactive thing, and then initiate the process upon approval, and then reprice only open orders. That is the one which will now, if an order is closed for receiving, then what happens, it will want to be repriced. So if you want to do that also, you have to remove it and then do it. And that's it. On the retroactive pricing, and then the thing is how to communicate to AP the change in the invoice alone. So the retroactive price invoice has to be done. Fine. So in EBIS, we have a retroactive price invoice concurrent that will be creating one more invoice for this. Now, it may even add or subtract the supplier's liability actually. So that portion is set to no. Fine. So one every night, I will now make another record and send it. Bye for now. And then this completes the retroactive pricing. Thank you.